What's up, everybody? Welcome to Podcast Now. I'm Alex, and in this video, I want to go over my tips and tricks for NHL 21. That's right. It's that time of the year. I've actually done this for the past, I think, like two or three NHL games, and I want to do it again for this game. And I got to be, you know, flat out honest with you guys, okay? I think people have said it as well. Going into this game, it's very familiar to those that have played it in the past, okay? Oftentimes, you know, if you maybe skip a couple entries, then you'll notice a really big jump. If you've played NHL 20, going into NHL 21, there are differences. I'm not going to say there's not. In fact, it makes, I think, these tips and tricks even more important. But there's not the biggest change in the world from one entry to the other, okay? I just want to make that pretty clear going, you know, up forward. So the biggest things, and this is kind of like for play now. This is for generally just when you're literally playing the game, okay? This isn't like a be a pro thing or like how to scam GMs in franchise mode or stuff like that. This is when you're actually playing the game. A lot of these I have said in the past years, and again, I think they become even more important. So the number one feature I think that this game does in terms of the actual gameplay, because it doesn't change all that much. Gameplay, it changes a little. Obviously, we have the new kind of like chip passes, which I do think are very important. I think they are very, very useful. You do want to use them. I would not overkill it, I would say. You have to kind of pick your zone. They have that. Obviously, you have like the Sidney Crosby stuff, the lacrosse goal, right? They've added a couple like specialty things, the Kucherov, fake deke that he used proudly on my Buffalo Sabres back in the day on Leonard. So you have those. You know, again, those are pretty difficult. I've seen like Nasher, right? Nasher on YouTube. He's done like tips and tricks of like how to do those things. I'm not going to get into how to do those like, again, specialty kind of dekes and stuff like that. That's kind of on its own. I want to talk about how you're actually playing the game. So the AI is smarter. Both, I would say, your team and the opposing team. Okay, and even the goalies. The goalies have set themselves up a whole lot better in terms of being ready for shots, more adjusting themselves in terms of rebound. So I would say the general tips of this stay pretty much the same for any game. And I think knowing or like watching hockey does kind of help you here, because for what it's worth, I do think these games are more and more closely related. Like, I think they do a really good job. I think NHL 20 did a really solid job of making the gameplay really feel as close as a game can feel to the actual NHL. So here's what I would say. You be smart, okay? You actually abide by the laws of the actual NHL. Passes when they make sense, okay? No extremely long outlet passes unless you know that you're able to make it. Going from D to D. Focusing, let's go attack first, okay? So when you're on the offense, okay? Constantly cycling the puck is the best way of doing it. The cross seam or like the cross crease kind of passes that lead to like one-timers, they used to be pretty easy ways to score goals. I think, again, a thing NHL has gotten better at as the years have gone on is generally the really easy, again, kind of like scamming the game. It still works. It just doesn't work as much. And I think, honestly, that's a good thing. I want to actually have to work for the goals, right? I actually do want to be able to cycle, do kind of like short end passes in order to open up a defenseman for a shot. Now, I love to work my shots, or the puck at least, to the defense, okay? That's not everybody's style, and I get that. Even if you look at, again, like NHL teams, some teams are powered by getting it to the defense and then going from there. Some teams are, again, more cycle heavy on the forwards and looking for, you know, prime opportunities. Again, I think it would completely depend on how you play, you know, how you actually play. But you have to be smart. You have to obviously control the puck. This is like my pro tip. It's the tip that I have stood by probably for like 5+ years that I still, and I'm very bluntly serious and honest about this. I do not see people doing the whole shielding the puck. Now, what do I mean by shielding the puck? I mean dragging the puck, whether it's to your right or to your left, depending on what, you know, hand your player is. And that is by holding the right analog stick and basically just dragging it as far to the one direction and then kind of curving it behind your body. I think it works extremely well. Then pressing, by the way, X or A on Xbox, using those things, and it is, it's shielding the puck. To me, it's always been the most dominant possession tactic that I've ever seen, okay? It's gotten better. Like, there are, if you, like, charge the person, you obviously can still hit them. It does, I think, generally make your player just like Hulk, like he's just able to take more of a hit than normal, okay? It's harder to poke check if you're a defenseman because you are literally dragging your stick and the puck to the farthest, opposite of the defenseman or of the forward, whatever, as humanly possible, okay? I think it works extremely, extremely well. It opens up, in my my mind, passing opportunities that may not be there in the first place. Because if you drag it, maybe you can shoot it around like the boards to somebody. Maybe you can have a quick pass like that. You can get, I would say, the enemy team or the opposition team to think you're doing one thing and then do the other. Because, again, you can pass it, but you could very easily do a nice wrist shot. And normally when I do wrist shots, I start there, and it kind of helps me aim. Obviously, you have to be – I think you have to be good at aiming. I think that's just something you get better at as you play the game, being able to pick corners, being able to pick areas of the goalie, whether it's five-hole. Obviously, the two, like, shoulders, like the two corners of the net become, like, pretty easy tactics, and whether that's one-timers or whether that is just a wrist shot, right? That's what I think you have to do. But that's really my pro tip. The rest of the offense, again, is pretty much, I would say, like the actual NHL. Obviously, the ice in the video games are much, much bigger. It's not like the real, you know, real world NHL where bodies, I think, are a lot closer together than what they are in the games. So using the available area and just possessing the puck. You know, offense doesn't get as tired as defense does when you're in the offense. So keeping the puck, they will end up slowing down. Again, constant rotations, I think, is the best way to go. And obviously, you're looking for the shot. You know, the goalies, like I said, are a lot better this time. So if you're going to do rebound kind of opportunities, I think they have to be very, very well placed. I think it is more of a situation where it is more like real life. Like, you will get those really nice rebounds sometimes, but not all that often. The goalies will, I would say, they will readjust a lot better now than they have in the past, okay? Defensively, well, it's kind of the same thing. You hope, I would, in terms of me, I hope that other players, right, people I'm playing online or whatever, even the AI, that they do not do that kind of, again, pro tip that I say for offense. But defense, well, here's what I'll say. I think the AI being smarter, your AI, okay, and even theirs, I guess, does help, I would say, both offense and defense, because offensively, your forward should be a whole lot smarter now. Again, we know the bank passes kind of thing that you can definitely work into the offense. Defensively, same kind of thing. The forwards and defensemen need to work together, and I think long gone are the days of the players just having absolutely no clue what the heck is going on, right? That was an issue, I would say, around like the NHL 15 to 17 period, where defensively it was just an absolute joke. They do, I would say, a pretty good job of tightening the gap between your team and their team, right? One player to another player. I would say it's become more important than ever. So say you're just playing a 5-on-5, you're playing against somebody else online, but you can control all the players. So the AI is controlling the other players that you are not. I would say it's never been more important than this year to really stay with, and I don't even mean stay with a guy. You can obviously change guys, but when you play, you locate the person you're supposed to go after, okay? So like wingers, obviously sometimes they're responsible for the point defenseman. The center could be an actual option for if you're trying to stop like a one-timer in the middle of the ice. I mean, you do have to think. I do think it, the game does, I think, benefit, or you benefit, you know, playing the game if you do watch the actual NHL. If you're focusing on where these players are actually supposed to be on the ice, where you think they're supposed to be, like in the real world hockey, I think that works a lot better. Defensemen are supposed to be those outlet passes into the forwards, okay? The defensemen are supposed to be tying people up in front of the net. The defensemen are supposed to go behind the net to retrieve the puck, and then sometimes you have other people come in. The AI, again, I think is a lot smarter this year, so I feel like that's going to help people out. Basically, it boils down to, again, defensively, and I did this last year. I did like an entire defense tips and tricks. Maybe I can do that if you guys want me to, a defense and an offense tips and tricks. But I would say, you need to get the puck. That's the entire point of playing hockey, right? You need to take the puck. But I would say you can cycle around all you want with your players, but stay on whichever guy you're focusing on. Don't, you know, again, the AI is smart, but I wouldn't let players start to get crisscrossed. That's the best way, I would say, for an opposition team to have a player open up. If you are playing, it's too many people. So say there's like a point guy. Say there's like a left defenseman, and you go after them as a forward, but then for some reason you change to another player and you also go after them. Well, now you've just, you know, opened up one of their team. So you don't want to do that. You want to make sure everybody's got their own man, and if somebody doesn't, you want to be able to, you know, fix that. Another thing too is, I think, again, playing the game more often, you do generally start to see things. You'll start to see, okay, there's a guy like kind of moving, maybe there's a defenseman that's like dropping down, like I know their plan probably is to get it to him for like a quick little wrist shot or a quick little like kind of like it just goes off his stick and in. Okay, you start to realize or recognize those things as you play more often, and if somebody's not on him, you don't want to, again, pull a guy off of somebody. You want to kind of find the area of the ice where there's like maybe two people instead of one person there, and you want to bring them back down, okay? You kind of want to let the game, I would say, do itself because the game is, again, smarter, but it will get confused just like any actual human. Again, for my Buffalo Sabres, they get confused all the time, right? One would wish to be able to invade their mind and pull them to another part of the ice, okay? So that's the goal here. And then finally, outlet passes. Again, when you get that puck, it's, again, more important than ever to get it out. I would really, if you're really, you know, try-harding, okay, if you're really going to try hard, I think the best way of doing it is to play it very, very safe. Get it to that open defenseman, get it to the winger on the side, and then go. Okay, you could do like a chip little pass. You could bank it off the boards yourself. You could even like just shoot it in the zone and go get it. Or if you're wanting to get like a quick change, you can do the same thing. But I would say play it generally safe. I mean, the errant, you know, just going straight down the middle or doing a pass like that, or, you know, if you're a defenseman and you think, because I sometimes do this, I'll sometimes change my lines when I'm in possession of the puck in my defensive end. But what will happen is you will be the only one there, the player you're playing as. So it's one versus, and it could be all of them. If they get on you and they get on you hard, it is very, very easy to lose the puck, and then you're completely, you know, you're out of luck and they're probably going to score. So best way of doing that, again, is just playing it very safe, passing it between the defensemen, looking for that open player, and going there. Outlet passes, just like in the real NHL, if your defensemen suck, Rasmus Ristolainen is a good example for Buffalo, then you're going to be in a lot of trouble, okay? It's not going to be very easy to get the puck out, or you'll just end up giving it back to them, okay? So, that's generally, I would say, my tips and tricks, the best ways, I think, of playing this game. Let me know in the comments below, guys, what do you think? What are some of your own tips or tricks? And let me know if you guys want to see other things. Like I said, I could talk about, you know, the offensive kind of things. I can talk about defensive. We can go in that route if we want to. I do want to talk about the future of the NHL games, like NHL 22. We'll do that in the future days as well. Let me know what you want to see. Make sure you guys are subscribed, as always, to this YouTube channel, Podcast Now. Hit the bell icon so you guys know when all these videos go up, and I will see you all on the next video.